Hey guys, Tony Maritato here, physical therapist, and in this video, I'm gonna go through the Harvard Health website's 7 exercises to do for frozen shoulder. Now, they've got a great article. I might not necessarily agree with every exercise they've chosen, but in this video, you're gonna see a demonstration of each of the 7 exercises, and I'm gonna talk about some of the things that clients might not realize how or why they're supposed to do those exercises when they're supposed to do it. So let's start with exercise number 1. It's called the pendulum. These are also called Codman exercises, but essentially when you think of the shoulder is essentially made up of 3 bones. We've got the humerus, which is the upper arm bone, the clavicle, which is the collarbone, and the scapula, which is your shoulder blade. Those 3 bones come together and they actually create the shoulder structure, and that floats over the rib cage. So if you think of my arm could weigh 8 to 12 pounds. It's hanging there. When I relax the musculature, the arm sinks down and we create a little bit of space inside the shoulder joint. The rotator cuff is 4 muscles that surround the shoulder. But within the shoulder joint, when somebody has a painful shoulder, an arthritic shoulder, it's the joint surfaces usually that are causing the pain or have the degenerative change. So the goal of the pendulum is to relax the shoulder, create a little bit of a suction cup effect, so the weight of the arm is pulling down and the musculature is totally relaxed. Typically, if you imagine my left shoulder is the one involved in the exercise, typically, we want a client to be close to horizontal, close to parallel with the ground. The involved upper extremity is just relaxed and hanging down. And the way I know that the therapist, rather the patient, is doing it right is as the body moves, the extremity trails. If your wrist and hips are moving together in exactly the same sequence, your shoulder is too tight. What should happen is my hips move forward, my hand follows, my hips move back, my hand follows, and it's just a dead weight on a string. Think of a pendulum just like this. Imagine that's your hand and your shoulders up here. As I swing back and forth, it's just a relaxed gliding motion. That's what we want to achieve through the shoulder. So typically we'll do about 20 front to back, we'll do about 20 side to side. You can do circles, clockwise, counterclockwise. You can also experiment with your hand position. When my hand is relaxed, it's usually facing the body. As I rotate my hand over, it's going to expose different structures of the shoulder. So that is the pendulum exercise.